What's up, guys? Matt Bell here at the Electric Violin Shop. We are talking about Fishman Loudbox amplifiers today. We've got two of them sitting right here. We've got the Fishman Loudbox Artist and the Fishman Loudbox Mini. And we're going to talk about those a little bit today. They are among the very few things that you can get string players to agree on. Most of it, we can't even agree how many strings are on a violin. Come on, man. So if you think we can get probably, I bet probably 80 or 90% of string players you talk to, whether they own a loud box or not, will tell you, yeah, they're great and they sound fantastic. 80% or 90% of violinists, my goodness, we couldn't agree on what color the grass is. But the loud box is one of those things that's been a long-standing thing for string players, and it's been a very, very popular amp among string players for very good reason. They sound fantastic. It's a great little family of amps. There's the Mini and the Charge. As of April 2021, when I'm filming this, those are the prices on those. The difference is not just the color, but there is a battery inside the Mini Charge, and we will get to the deets on that in just a minute. The Loudbox Mini has two inputs. It's got an instrument input and a mic input. And then there's a physical aux input as well as a Bluetooth input if you want to play along with tracks or something. It's got 60 watts. It's got two effects in it. It's got reverb and chorus. And then it has a single XLR out. It is not a, we wouldn't call it like a super full function amp. It's sort of more like a budget amp. $300 and some is a really reasonable price for pretty small, very portable. It's super lightweight, it's under 20 pounds, and you can just cart it with you wherever you go. It does not have a headphone out. It does not have an effects loop. It doesn't have separate control for the tweeter. It does not have phantom power on that mic input. And like I said, it doesn't have two instrument inputs, just one. So if those are, if you can live with the limitations of this amp, it is a very popular amp among people that do not need these things. If you need a few more features in your amp, you might be looking for the Loudbox Artist. And here's the price on that as of April 2021. This has a lot more features. It's not just a bigger, louder amp. It has a lot more features. It's got two combo jacks. And what we mean by combo jacks is a special jack that you can plug either a quarter inch or a microphone, XLR, into that. So you can have two instruments or two mics. It does have a physical and a Bluetooth aux in if you want to play along with some tracks. Instead of 60 watts with the Mini, it's got 120 watts, but it's split up 100 watts to the main driver and then 20 watts to the tweeter, which you can adjust separately. Has eight different effects in there, and we're going to play those for you in a minute. Has a really cool feedback notch sweep in there. If you start getting some feedback in your acoustic electric or your acoustic with a pickup, you can start sweeping this feedback notch, and it will. It's a sweepable notch filter, so you can work on your feedback with that. It has Bluetooth in. It's got three XLR outs, so there's one for each of the two input channels and a combined. So if you're sharing an amplifier with somebody, maybe it's you and a guitar player, you can send a combined output or you can send separate outputs if you guys want to use this as a monitor and then still have a sound guy who's mixing the two of you separately. That's pretty cool. Does have a headphone out. It has two effects loops, one for each input channel. It's got a foot switch which allows you to access some other features, some muting and all that sort of thing. And like I said, it does have an adjustable tweeter. I'm going to let you hear a little bit of sound here in a second. I'm going to use an Aurora Oro violin. It's a passive instrument. And I'm going to play three times. One is going to go direct into the interface that you're listening to. It's a Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 interface. And then the next one is going to go direct into the Fishman Loudbox Mini and then out to the Scarlett. And then the other one's gonna go direct into the Artist and then out to the Scarlett. So you'll be able to hear, there's no reverb, it's super dry, super close, but you'll be able to hear the sound of just sort of the difference of the preamp inside the loud box versus just the preamp inside the Focusrite. Mm-hmm. All right, magic, I'm back with no fiddle in my hand. How cool is that? So the next thing I did, I tested the 8 different effects on the Fishman Loudbox Artist. And you'll see on the screen what they are, just a very short clip so you can hear those. And that is a direct out sound with no mic in the room or anything. It's just direct out straight to the interface. Right, so we're going to put some specs on the screen right here so you can pause this if you want to study these specs a little bit. I'm not going to read them to you. You guys can read. But these are just from the manual. This is from the Mini and the Charge. And you can see here, I did say that I would mention the battery life. They say average is about 12 hours. And then here are some specs for the Loudbox Artist. Page 1. And then there's a page 2. So, if you want to study these, you can pause the screen right now. Again, these just come from the Fishman manual. In any case, I just want you to know that these are really, really fantastic amps. They sound great. They've got a ton of features and stuff in them. We're going to do a Facebook Live today if you want to come back. If you want to hear a lot more playing through these amps, you can go to the Electric Violin Shop Facebook page and look on April 21st. 2021, and we're going to go quite a bit longer. We'll probably go close to an hour, and we'll do a bunch of playing, and we'll experiment with octave pedals so you can hear. Spoiler alert, the Mini is okay with cello. The Artist is really quite good with cello. So we're going to go a lot deeper on our Facebook page, but I just want to give you guys sort of a short review of these two amps and tell you that they're fantastic. We really love them.